Two N's and Doug Van.
Replies to Doug.
The only difference between Doug and dog is you. It goes in waves. I get it. Insofar, this is views demystified, but I discovered there's no way doing CCK demystified, so I'm going to try to combine the two. Out of the box, Drupal has pages and stories. You create a page, you create a story. Stories automatically appear on the front page, and then once you have 11 of them, they go off to page 2 with item 1 at the top. And you're actually, you know, obviously everything, you create a page, you create a blog post, a product review, a job post, whatever, you're stashing all this data in the database. CCK allows you to take a content type like a blog post. If you were with me, there I am, 20 years ago. Always keep 20-year-old pictures of yourself around. You have no idea when you're going to need them. So we created the blog post earlier. We changed the front page to blog. We created the About Us page and the home link. The About Us link and the home link.
Oh, yeah.
Much more contrast on my 19-year-old face there. Thank you for the likes. So the blog post was what the blog post is. I didn't make sense. So looking at this first one, the first blog post, it is what it is. I gotta log in. Oh, to the wireless, right, okay.
All about the login.
I remember Ada. Someone shout it out to me. KS38, okay, KS38. KS38, upper H. And then SQA.
Did
you use your name? I thought it was Ada. Did I type it wrong? KS38, upper H, SQA. I've been typing it wrong all week, all day, until I'm finally in front of a camera. Okay. So you can hear me back, everything's fine. So here was our blog post, here's the first one. I'm going to edit this. And all I have is the title, the taxonomy of worker play that we created just after lunch, the body of this wonderful blog post, and then the usual information. I don't have a menu item because we agreed that having a menu item for every blog post is going to be kind of silly. But I want to put an image. I can have a WYSIWYG right here, I can put an image in mine, but I want to have kind of a field. I want to upload an image into a field and associate every blog post with an image. How do I do that? Well, I got to turn on CCK. And I've turned on a few things since last we met. I have the module filter module is now turned on. So I can go over here to CCK, and I can turn on content, because the CCK module out of the box is like 4 or 5 modules, and then there's a bunch more. So I'm just going to turn on the ones I need. Content, file field, image field, and widget options. That's all I need to put in a link or an image upload button. I can put text and numbers and node references and embedded media fields if I download that module. I'm going to save this. This is the module filter module at work that I'm doing. It's very awesome. Here you go. So I'm saving this page. Now, I'm going to go into my blog content type, which only has title, body, and usual things, turn off and on comments and what have you. I'm going to add something to it. Configuration has been saved. So content management, content types, blog entry, manage fields. Manage fields was not an option previously. There were no fields to manage. Well, technically there still aren't, but I can manage it by creating one. So here's the manage fields interface. I can put the body, which we've always had, above the title. That's dumb. I'm not going to do it. That'd be very counterintuitive for our users. So author information, publishing information, I can change things around all I like. What I really want to do here, though, is add a field called image. And now the field underscore, I'm actually creating a new column in the database that's going to gather this information. And on some occasions, you're actually creating a new table, a completely new table in the database. And any SQL engineers, MySQL database, admin, all of us, including him, are going to be creating tables and columns. But Drupal's going to do it for us, so we're all database admins now, okay? Ask your boss for a big raise, because you're a database admin. Okay. He already was. You go home making as much as you can. That's sad. I got to do something for you. You should all pass a hat. Now, an image is a file. Before it was an image, it has to be a file. And then what kind of a file is it? It's an image, okay? I can have people upload PDFs and Word docs. You know, submit your resume for the job application. I'm not gonna use file for image for that. I'm gonna use file upload if I was doing that, right? So, but in this case, I am using an image. And Drupal wants to know what kind of a file this is because it's gonna treat it very differently. There are operations we can perform on you. What are they gonna send me? So I've saved this, and here's your helper text. If I have people, you know, you're all the users of my big blog site, I'm gonna say, submit your image, we hope that you're gonna be reasonable about this and not put anything nasty up. Your account will be stripped of you immediately, no questions asked, and you will not get it back if you're gonna be a jerk about it. Here are the acceptable file extensions, and if you try to upload something beyond that, it's just not gonna work. Maximum minimum resolutions, typically we let the server handle that. If you want to put up a 6 gig image, good luck. You're probably going to fail in the end. Path settings, where's this file going to be stored? Because you're putting a file in my file structure. The file's not going to the database, obviously. The file name is. So I can establish a specific path where all these are going to go to. And if I had the token module on, I could have the path be blog images / user in brackets / nothing. Which means it creates a folder. The first time you upload an image, it creates a folder with your name on it. And I can go up and look at all of your images and see if you've been loading nice. All text settings, enable a custom alternate text. So when they upload an image, it gives them a little feel. Hey, you know, this be nice for the usability aspect and give you something, a feel for that. So for simplicity, I'm not gonna cover all these. Required, let's make it required. Number of values, I just want one image, or I want two, or I want five. Or I want unlimited. You submit an image, hit the more button. Another upload widget. Submit an image, hit the more button. Another image widget, and you upload as many as you like. In the database, those have delta values, so I know which one was first, second, and third. The list field. When I look at the blog type that you submitted, the blog post you submitted, do I see a listing of the file name, and people can click on it, and you'll see it? Not necessarily, it doesn't sound very practical, but somebody needs it, so it's there. And when you do it, description field, I want you to put a description of this. Well, really, your image is supporting this big blog, so hopefully they're complementary, and I don't need an additional explanation of your image. So I'm just gonna say disabled on that. Now I'm gonna save my field settings. Am I saving an image? Am I saving a blog post? I'm creating a framework, if you look at the house analogy, perhaps, the blog content type now has, I added a room on it. If you will. So this is the framework side of Drupal. You're not even making content. And when you want to port a site over, here's a static site, or an ASP site, or WordPress, or Joomla site, port it over to Drupal. What are my content types? What are my fields? What kind of field validations? Image fields, file fields, embedded media fields, number fields, computed fields. This field needs to equal the average of these five values. There's a computed field for that. There are so many CCK field modules. I need a field that responds to this and does this and allows the user to input this. There's probably a module for that, because someone else needed it before you do. So down here is the image field. I'll put it towards the top so you can see it more nicely. So I'm going to save this. So I can add fields all day long, all day long. Remember the taxonomy that we added before? The word played appears right there. You can put it below, you can move it around. So this has been saved. Now I'm going to go back and look at my existing post over here at the home. Now the existing post of first blog does not have any image yet. Okay, I've created a space for it, so let's edit this. And there's the upload widget for files, for pictures. And what did I do? I think I had something I wanted to publish. What's picture 39? I should probably take a look. Oh, Drupal Camp Asheville, okay. So a picture from Drupal Camp Asheville logo. So I'll open that up. Now these are all going to be as big as they are. If you use the image cache module takes in the image as big as it is, and the image cache module will say, okay, whenever I go to render an image on a blog post, all of your blog posts, someone's got a really big camera, someone's got a really cheap camera, someone's got an icon sized image, someone else is doing billboard quality, high def. Whenever I go look at all these blog posts, every image will be scaled and cropped to X by Y, and it's going to look nice, and it's going to download very quickly. Now, over in their folder, I have the 50 meg version, but when I render, I'm just going to deliver out this, this 24K or 5K if you need my word. So I upload the image, if I didn't already, and there's my little example, so I know I got the right image. Now I'm going to save this. And there it is, okay? Now, there's a little label that says image. Did anybody not know that was an image? Did that label really kind of convince you? Let's get rid of that. How do you get rid of it? Over in content management, oh, come on, mouse for me. Content types, blog entry. Now, manage fields is where I added the image field. Display fields tells us, you know, tells people, how do I going to display this field? Well, in the case of the image field, it asks us the label. The label appears above the image. Well, how about the label appears hidden, which means it doesn't appear at all. So we don't need that, do we? And that's in the case of the teaser, and over here on the full node. And then, by the way, your label positioning affects both the teaser version and the full node version. Now, if I had image cache installed, I'd drop this down, and I would say image cache preset 300 by 200 as a link to the original image. So when you click Bob's picture of him having a good time at the beach, you click it, all of a sudden, whoa, you've got scroll bars, because it was a 15 meg image, and you didn't know that until you clicked it. It took forever to load. But everybody gets the small picture first, then you can click it. So one of my options would be image cache preset 300 by 200 as link to original image. But as for now, I'm just gonna make it the image, and you can have other options there as well. So I'll save that and go back to my blog post. And there it is, pretty big. So I could really benefit from having image cache, but that's a whole nother hour. And then the image label is gone, which is good. Now I'm gonna cheat. We're gonna do some Julia Child style here. Reset site. While I was almost listening to the previous session, I went ahead and created a bunch of content we're gonna use to play with some views. Or you should want to reset the site later. The demonstration module, demo module, drupal.org/project/demo, allows you to take database snapshots of your site at different stages. Like when you wake up, set a stage, okay, just copy. And then around after lunch, you're like, man, I have really hosed this. And I'm trying out these modules I learned about in Atlanta, and I've just got, the front page is missing now, and like nobody can log in. And I've got one user, I've got my admin logged in, and I'm afraid to log out, so I'll never get back. Well, pop in here and restore the entire site to where you were that morning.
What module is that?
Demo. Drupal.org/project/demo. Some guy did this, and I'm using it to go ahead in time. I'm going to the future. Join me as we go back to the future. And it tells me all the modules that were installed when that snapshot was taken. You can see it in the future here, and later I have more modules. So I'm going to reset to that point. And now I have still the handsome devil appear. That didn't change. But what I do have now is that content type also created in here. And I have 50 nodes, ladies and gentlemen, or if not more. Look at all this content. Causa sit exputo hook. That's my favorite list. So these are all the devel modules. Drupal.org/project/devel has a generate. It's a suite of modules. As many modules are, you download one, you get 5 or 6. And it has a content create, and it created all these posts. And they're very pretty. Here's one of them. And there's even comments to these. Okay, that's pretty cool. Okay, so there's 50 or 36 nodes of blog posts, and we can imagine that they're all, you know, a couple of, you each submitted a couple of them. And I want a page that shows, I want a block on my sidebar, that shows me the 10 most recent blog posts, okay? How do I do that? Because right now, I can go to the home page, and it shows me 10 of the teasers. And you know, I'm kind of looking, you know, that's the 10 most recent there, but I've also got the teaser going on. But as you navigate through the site, and when you're on the About Us page, and when you're on the contact form, which we never did build after lunch, I don't know, I just got sidetracked. As you're going to navigate through the site, I always want to keep the 10 most recent blogs up here, just titles, and then you click on it and link. So I'm just, you know, that's a reasonable thing to do. So I've turned on the Views module. The Views module has 3 modules: Views UI, that's your user interface to create views. And then Views Export, which allows you to export a view into a file. And actually, it just gives you a bunch of text you can copy. And then you can pop over to another site, do a Views Import, pop in that text, and the exact same view is going from site to site. That's pretty cool. Uh-oh. I've got a PHP memory error. White screen of death is what happens when you We're out of memory. Sadtrombone.com is where you go. Is where you go when you get sad. When you get a last minute death. And boy, I should have had that pulled up already. Have that loaded up. I know we've only got one session left. If someone goofs up, you're a presenter. Hit them with a sad trombone. I've done it. And this is my 11th campus here. I've been presenting at, and I've hit somebody in almost every camp. Okay, so enough playing with that. Let's get back to you. Back to the gig. Was it slowly loading? No. Okay. And if I have to, I will go to govman.com and use examples there. Which is why, in a pinch, we go to govman.com and use examples there. So site building views. And I do have a lot of blog posts, of course, at govman.com. So let's create a new one. So add. Here are all the views that exist. Now I mentioned CCK, you're all database admins and you're all pulling in six figures now. You're glad you came to this session. So all this data is in the database. These job posts, these blogs, these recipes, these product reviews, big deal, you gotta get them out. How are you gonna get them out? I'm gonna add a view called recent blog posts. Right? And actually that's a machine name. Contains only alphanumeric. Oh, I almost caught myself there. My resolution's set for the projector, not for my screen. It's hard to see over here. And then usually I put the same name in there. Not the word same name, but the same name. I'm in a hurry. And the options are I can show a view of nodes, a view of aggregated items. I can pull in news feeds and make views of those. Views of comments, showing all the comments that are in the last 10 comments. Showing the last 10 comments. I can show all the files, I can show revisions, I can show terms. There are a lot of things I can create views of, but I don't want to create views of nodes because I don't want to create views of blog posts and blog posts or nodes. I go from right to left, I'm RTL on my views, I go from the right. So my site's full of content. There are many things in my site. I'm going to start off with my filter. So if we've got to zoom in, we've got 40,000 feet, we've got to zoom in on this. When you look at filtering, there are many groups to filter from. The comment fields, the content fields that you create with CCK, date fields, node fields, node access fields, search, taxonomy, I mean, there's a lot of all these options. Node is the group I start with, because here's what I want to know. Here is node published. I want to know, is a node published, yes or no? I only want nodes that are published. If a blog post has been published, one of you got all irate at somebody and published a big nasty blog, and someone's like, dude, you better unpublish that before she sees it. And you begrudgingly go and check the unpublished box, but you leave it there. You don't delete it because you're like, I might come back and republish that. I don't want to show the last 10 posts and show yours when it's not published. The good thing is, if I do show that link, they'll click it and it'll be access denied because no one can view unpublished content. But why have bad links on your list? So I'm going to check for it's published or not. And I don't want to show all the content on my site. I only want to show what? Blog posts. So node type is a filtering option here. So I'm going to filter by these two things. Now, my first question that I get is published yes or no? I haven't been published yet. Only showing the published, so yes. And then I hit that. It is one of, oh no, what do I pick here? What do I do?
T-shirts.
Blog entries. What's someone else say?
T-shirts.
T-shirts. So then I get this, so I have two filters up here, and now I get an error, or sometimes an error. It says, display defaults uses fields, but there are none defined, or they're all excluded. Well, here's my fields section. By the way, this is the default. I'm not creating a view technically yet, I'm creating a default idea of a view, and I've got 26 minutes to finish it. So I'm gonna add some fields. And by the way, right, I'll keep on going right to left. So I'm gonna add some fields. What was it I said I wanted to show on this? I wanted a little sidebar that had
titles.
What module provides the titles of nodes? Mm-hmm. What group would node do you have? So under the group of node, I'm not going to show that it's published. I can show yes or no if it's published. That's dumb. I can show the title. Title, there she is. Node title. Save. Or add. Now is that the end? I want this title to be a link to the node. So I got to look for some options in here, and there's one right there. Link this field to its node. Okay, that's awesome. And here's your label again. Label. I think I know what a title looks like. I'm taking that label out. My users don't need to be told what a title is. So now I'm going to update my default view. And look at this. Look at this. I've got a preview of what this is going to look like. The first blog post on my new site. Now look at this. This is the very first blog. And that's not, did I say I wanted to show the first 10 blogs I ever had? What did I say I wanted to do? The most recent. Okay, so I gotta do some kind of sorting. Let's go to the sort section. Sort criteria. Let's sort by the published date of the node. Where would that be?
Node
what?
Published date.
Node post date. Okay? Who's got a coin they can quickly grab so we can flip it on the answer I need?
Tails,
okay, he says tails. So when I sort by the post date, heads is ascending, tails is descending. Let's go descending. I can honestly never remember which is which. And I bet if I took a poll, I'd get like almost a split. And sure enough, descending is right. Thank you, Tails. So now, my little preview here, I haven't created my view and my users can't see my view, and I haven't created a display, but this is the framework again, the framework side of Drupal. Well, I just want to get on my WordPress site and publish pages and posts. I don't want this. That's cool, okay? You wasted $20 and you had a good meal and you hung out with me. But but if you do want to get jiggy with it and do some awesomely wicked cool stuff in a dynamic way with a GUI, welcome to Drupal. And it's hard because I could go on for, I could do a day. In fact, I'm doing 2 days for this, for a company I can't mention. Maybe a third day. So that's my default. So I got it sorted real nice. Here it is, items to display, 10. I can change that. Up here it says the title. I haven't given it a title yet. Let's give it a title of, well, you know what, I'm not going to give it a title. I don't feel like giving it a title. So let's go over to the defaults. Oh, and here's a page or two. I'm going back and forth. Somebody stop it. Use pager, no. How about use pager, yes. How about a full pager? What's a pager? You probably already got ahead of me on this. Now look at this. I've got these 10, and then I got some pagination going on with next and last, okay? And there were different kinds of pagers in there. There are modules that offer you different ways of rendering this. There are modules that can add, see, this looks complicated enough. This can get really long by adding lots of cool stuff. Out of the box, Views allows you to create, oh my goodness, this is not out of the box. I've got a lot of modules installed, I'm sorry. Among these, the ones that you will have available to you out of the box is page, feed, block, and attachment. A page is a page. If I create a view, if I'm going to have a page of blog links, I'm probably going to do more than 10 so I can fill up the height. If I'm going to do a block is, of course, you know, something on the side panels. You know, I wouldn't really want a block in the header or a block in the footer, not of this kind. So I put it in my sidebar first and sidebar last. If I do a feed, I did have a feed, drupal.com/blog/something is a feed that drupal.org/planet picks up. Drupal.org/planet picks up approved blog posts, Drupal blog posts, and syndicates them to drupal.org/planet. If you have a cool Drupal blog, or you occasionally have some of your blogs about Drupal, I have a taxonomy term for my Drupal, for my blogs. If I tag it as Drupal Planet, then that gets picked up by the Drupal Planet feed. Aggregator, it grabs my feed, and it sniffs out my URL. Does it have anything new? No. Does it have anything new? No. It keeps on coming and checking me out, and about once a month, and sometimes twice, I eke out a post. So I can create a feed, and I created a feed for that. And then an attachment, I can have a view on top of a view. Here's a view of 10, maybe on a page. Here's a view of 10 links, the 10 most recent blog posts. Under that is the 10 most recent comments. And I have two views on one page. One of those views is a page display, and the other one is an attachment display attached to that page display. I didn't want to wax over that. I had to tell you there was at least four displays out of the box in Drupal. So I'm going to actually now create a block, because I wanted this in the side panel, right? So I'm going to sidebar. So add display. Now my display for block has inherited all my default values. Okay, and that's a good thing. And now I want to give it a name. I'm going to give it the name of sidebar recent blog posts. Okay, and then update default display? No. I want to override and update only this display. Okay, because I may want to create next an attachment or a page or a feed. I can use these default settings as the basis to create all kinds of displays, numerous block displays, whatever I like. So I'm gonna save this, because I haven't even saved it yet. I mean, all this is like suggestive. It's non-committal, it's not committed, it doesn't exist. When I save it, I will have a new block available. Recall I moved the user block and I got rid of it. What else did I do? I created a custom block with a space bar in it, hoping to make some room. Is that your question about making the space? Who was that?
Yeah.
I was just testing myself. So I've now created another block and I got to go way over here. Yeah, Drupal makes you jump around, but you get really cool stuff done. So here's my blocks display. Down here in the disabled, by default it's disabled, there should be a really long, what did I call it? Sidebar? Is it at the bottom? Oh, this is my website, this is my personal site, that's why. I'm going to do a find for sidebar. No, not recent. So recent blog post, that's what I'm starting back with. Recent blog, okay, here we go. So here's a block under disabled, trust me, that's the disabled section. It's called recent blog posts block. Okay. So recent blog posts was the name of the view. Remember that? Has the underscores. And then the block is the display that I just created when I added display based on the default settings. Right now it has no rendering. I'll throw it on the sidebar, on the right sidebar, because this theme actually uses left and right sidebar, which, you know, we can't stop them. I don't think it's the best idea. I'm going to save this. Now I already have a recent post section on my site. But now I have two, here's sidebar, recent blog posts, right? So that title that I created is now put up here, and I can use some CSS and shrink that down. Wow, that already was shrunk down once, okay. And then here's my recent post, and then here's my pager. Ooh, having a pager and a block looks kind of funky, doesn't it? What did I do in reality? Over here's my recent blog posts, and I just put a more button. A more button. Now, where'd the more button come from? It says, read the latest blog entries. I forget how I built that letter more, but that more button. I don't remember. But suffice to say, there are models to do things, and there are things you can do for yourself. And then when you did it a year and a half or two ago, you forgot how you did it. Was a module available then, or did I do it myself? I don't remember. So we have all these blogs and other things, t-shirts, and I have a Uber cart instance in here where I demonstrate how to use Uber cart. So I have all this content here in pages, and what is Drupal, all about DVDs reviewed, recent blogs, Twitter feeds, talk about my Drupal training, which I'd love to provide for you and your organization, and a contact form. I have all this content, but this view filters by, is it published, is it a blog entry, show me 10, in a block, go. Fair? I can also sort by how many comments each blog post has. So most commented on blog posts, you know, like what's the buzz? And then it lists, you know, the three or four blog posts that have the most comments. I don't get a lot of comments on my website, on my blogs, but if I did, that could be something fun to do. So you can add all kinds of really cool stuff. 16 minutes. How are we doing on views? Is it making sense? Questions about views? Yeah? Over here?
How do relationships work?
How do relationships work, the man asks?
Just in views.
Just in views? Yeah. Well, I'm a huge fan of Dr. Phil, and his answer to that, no. How do relationships work? Let's do that, okay? Relationships, okay, no reference is one of your CCK fields. If you turn them on, it's available in the CCK default, or CCK original suite. So I have, what's a good example? I've done this before. Okay, I built a law firm, no I didn't, I built a website for a law firm. Much different. And there were four offices for this, you know, there were almost 200 attorneys, paralegals, directors, shareholders, and we had a lot of people in here. And they were spread across four offices. And when you go to the attorney's bio page to read up on this thing, what's this person all about? The office and address is right there on the page. Do you suppose we pasted the same address into every user's profile? That's kind of silly. I created a node type called office. And it had a simple body field. I think I just used the default body field. And I threw in all the data right there. Because I didn't need to do any logic on these values. That's the office or it's not. Okay. So I had four office nodes. And they're probably back to back, like 120, 101, 102, 103, because I probably created them all at one instant. And then when Kent, our videographer, gets hired at this law firm, We're going to start filling up, you know, where you go to school, different kind of things. And there's a drop-down selector that says, you know, what office is he in? And when you choose the Minneapolis office, you're actually a node reference to node 122 main. Maybe it's node 122. So then when I go to render Kent's biography page, I'm going to say, okay, hey, pull in the body field from node from the node in the node reference section. And that's what relationships does. I can say, there is a relationship with the office content type. And then when I come down here to show to print out the node body on fields, when I render node body, I can render the node body for Kent's bio field, bio node is a user profile, that body. And then I can choose node body again. And I'm not going to show the body directly twice. I'm going to say, when you show this body, use the relationship to the office. Show me that body. And that is wicked cool. Okay? You can have some wicked many-to-many going on, and you can get really, really freaky with that. That is awesome. That is the shortest, best description I've ever given you that. Thank you for asking. Now, if you're argumentative, we have arguments. And don't mix arguments and relationships. It doesn't work out. No, it does, actually. In real life, no, we've used it does. Arguments is cool. And I got to show off Leonard.com. And throw up your hands. I could do 5 days on views. People, this is Leonard.com. This won an award, a tie for second place like a week and a half or two ago for, I think it was specifically law firm marketing websites. But it got a tie for second place for being a good marketing site. And doggone, I was a lead developer on this, and we worked our tails off, and I found knowledge I didn't know existed, and I did see some awesome stuff. And man, you don't know what you can do until you got to do it, and you're like, the deadline's coming. So here's last name. And in retrospect, this should be grouped, but let's go with the V's. So the letter V. So attorney's last name V. This is a view down at the bottom. This is a view, and only two results came back. This is a view of all user profiles where they are checked as being an attorney, not a shareholder, not a director, not a paralegal. These are just I think it's a taxonomy term, actually. So the filter is taxonomy. So filter is published. Published, yes, node type, biographies, taxonomy term, attorney, and then the argument is set to last name begins with this letter coming in, okay? If that were A, then it runs that same query and says last name begins with A. That's the argument of the view, okay? I no longer have access to this site. It's been out in production for maybe close to a year now. So I don't have access. But that's an argument for you. Yeah? Anybody argue with that?
No.
So that's cool. So CCK makes you a database admin, and it's creating tables and records, and views makes you a database admin, pulling the data out and rendering in cool ways. A slideshow. We've all seen slideshows on various websites. When you see one, that could be view slideshow module, which creates not page, not feed, not block, but a slideshow. There's a views rotator module. There's J carousel, and just Google, you know, Drupal slideshow, and there's probably more modules that have come out. And there are 50 ways to skin that cat. That was a Paul Simon song, by the way. But I need to show. So there are modules that make things different. I don't want a list. I want a scrolling. It doesn't have to be a big graphic. I want a little text box that goes. You know, they can make a scroll that way. Just a little bit of text. Like testimonies from our customers. Oh, they're awesome, they rock. And then it flips out. They saved my butt big time. And swaps out. That's always cool, isn't it? CCK and views. Wow, man, I can't believe I have 11 minutes left. Did I just cover everything about CCK and views? I'll do it again. That's true. Second verse in was words. Really? Okay. Then, treat me that way about it. Looking at some of my existing views, one trick I did, this is my blocks. Any PHP programmers in the house? Just a couple? PHP programmers? Just a couple, okay. The actual view I use for my recent blog posts has a little trickery in it. Oh, I gotta kill that one too. Crap. That's like live out in the wild. Is this one right here? Edit. Okay. So, you know what? All I gotta do is go to the block and turn it off. I'm gonna go to this block and do a remove display, and then save it, and then I'm no longer bombarding the world with that little block there. Okay, it's going. I still have a nice one. So then I'll go back to my list, and I'll find the one I do use. Now remember how I don't use recent blog posts. Which one do I use? Remember I don't use the promote to front page, because no one has a river of news in the front page, really. This one is not the one I'm using because it has no displays. These are not the droids I'm looking for. Yeah, I was like letting off on you guys in my first couple of sessions. I didn't have music references and everything else. You know, just like popping some really wild stuff. Here we go. Here's a bunch of displays. Okay, look over here. This is the one that actually drives this block you see before you. Kid you not. Look over here. Is Node filter? Is Node published? Yes. Okay. Is Node type blog story? Blog entry? Yes. Is it promoted to the front page? Okay. That checkbox does nothing with your front page unless that site information, that last field, says no. Remember? It went in doubt, use Node, he said. So this becomes a flag that can use. You want to flag your content as featured. You want to flag your content as something special. I have all these things, but the first, fifth, and seventh, and eighth need to be included in a rotating carousel somewhere. Then use your front page, promote front page check as just a flag, and run your filter by that. So what I do is over here on my recent blog posts, I don't have I deselect some of my blog posts. If I do a blog post that's kind of humorous or something non-technical, then I don't promote it to the front page, which means it never shows up in the recent blog posts. It does show up on the front page pagination, though. My front page pagination looks like this. There's the newest post, down to the bottom, and then keep on going. So all my posts show up here. Okay, this is hand-coded. This is not a view. You should usually use views, but I had an edge case. I wanted to do something, so I did that. That advance. Next. Oh, you know what? Oh, the newest blog post always shows up at the top. I just now realized that. That's fascinating. I'll fix that later. But so you can find all my blog posts by pagination at the bottom. But over here, they only show up if I in that list, if I check the promote to front page. So there's a little free trick for you. You can use that as a flag. You need more flags, use the flag module, drupal.org/project/flag. The cool thing about the flag module is when you're looking at the content, you can hit a little button that flags and unflags right there without editing it and going into some checkbox. Because you're admin, I think we use that for the featured content, featured attorneys on the front page of people page. Jerry, Aaron, and Jill, if I was logged in looking at Jerry's page, I believe I have a featured button right here. I can just hit it, unfeature, and hit it again, feature it again. And that's really a little cool interface. And then Views is aware of that. Every time you add a field or some kind of functionality to a node, Views says, someday I'll use that if you want me to. And you pop in and say, hey, Views, sniff that out, and do this if it's that, do that if it's this. Make sense? So that's the power of Views. 6 minutes for questions on CCK or Views. Yeah. WordPress and Joomla are trying their best to replicate this functionality. Right.
If you use the publish to front page as a flag, how do you make it not published on the front page?
Right. If I'm using the checkbox as a flag, how am I getting it to not actually promote to the front page as well? Because my front page is controlled by a custom module that I wrote, not by what's promoted to the front page. And the way I did that, without showing you my code, that'd be way long, is over on the site configuration, site information. I have so many modules on, guys, I can't even find my stuff. Site information is probably the last thing on yours. but mine is like 20 more options. Very, it's very bottom. DVBlog is a path that's created by the hook menu API, the menu, Drupal API, the hook menu function, and it creates that path and makes it legitimate, and then I have it output some very cool stuff. But irrelevant to that, DVBlog could be a node. Node 5 could have a URL path alias of DVBlog. Okay, let's imagine it does. If I make this node, and actually I'm not going to do that. So that's my front page, DVBlog, not the river of news of things that are promoted. But here's a funny thing. If I go up here and go to dougvan.com/node, wouldn't you know it, this is all the information and all the posts in my site that are promoted in front. Let's go to Drupal Camp Atlanta. .com/node. And they have no content promoted in the front page. Whitehouse.gov/node, they've taken it out. You can defeat that functionality because you may not want them. Because, you know, I think last, I would show you some people that I know do that, but it's probably not cool in video. We'll talk later. Is there a question over here as well?
I just
want to
know if you have any examples of where you've used attachments.
Yes, back on the letter, examples of when I've used attachments. Now, attachment sounds like attaching a file, doesn't it? Get away from that. That blew my mind. I wasn't born knowing all this, guys. I'm going to be a shock. But there are just so many things that just stand right in your way saying, you're not going to pass me. You are not going to understand this. And calling that attachment, oh, dear Lord. It's not an attachment. And then someone wrote, Larry Garfield, I'll call him out because he's already confessed to this ill. He created a module that creates a new display called Views Attach. Now maybe that's the attachment. No. Insult to injury. But it's an awesome module, and it's how we create galleries. Lullabod.com has a video on how to create awesome image galleries using the Views Attach module. Every gallery is a node, every image is a node. You have node references of images to the gallery. When you go to the gallery, it's an attachment of Views Attach of all those nodes that are coming in from the relationship. It is the coolest, wickedest gallery. There's a gallery module, and not very versatile, kind of lame. But when you make your own out of the Lego pieces, because you buy the Lego car, it is what it is. I want to add a, you got to melt the plastic and get, you know, you got to get, no. The Lego car is what it is. You use the Lego pieces, CCK, Views, Views Attach, etc. You create this beast that is awesome. Here's Views Attach. Show me the three most recent alerts created across the whole site. I don't care who created them. That's my page display. Here is an attachment display that attaches to the page display, appears under. So this is an attachment that appears under page. Show me the most recent three newsletters. Here's an attachment display that appears below attachment newsletters display.
Can you do the same thing with panels?
You can do the same thing with panels. There's panels everywhere, and then there's panels nowhere. And if this client's going to be managing the site, I didn't want to hand off a complicated machine for them to deal with. Panels is there are some things panels can do that you have to use panels for, period. And if you're going to do that, then you might consider just going panels for the whole site, because it should be an all or nothing. And I didn't want to use panels just for this case. Yes?
Will those show up in your blocks list if you attach them?
The show up as blocks. No. An attachment is not a block. An attachment is viewed, because so here's the page display, and it has a URL of /resources, and views must show that on the resources page. This display over here is an attachment attached to that page. So when views shows that page, it must show that. I could make a bunch of blocks and throw the blocks in here. Does that make sense? You love that?
You solved a huge problem.
I solved a huge problem. Wow. I'll put you in my fresh books. My fresh book, yeah. That's a good answer. The questions are coming out now that I have less than a minute left. All of a sudden, it's like, oh, solve my client issue. 2 minutes.
So when do you attach that? How do you do that?
How do you so when do you attach that? Pardon?
Is there like something you have to say, hey, attach this here?
Did you say the word code? This is a user interface, brother. I mean, I love all my coder friends, and they know their place. That joke's like, you gotta be like, what, in your 40s plus to get something like that? That's a good one. Where's my good example here? I'll go over to my recent, I gotta cook on this one now, I'm gonna be rushing. Recent edit. Okay, so here's a page display, right? I'm gonna create an attachment display right now, and all it has is the defaults. Ideally, I wanna change something and not have the same data twice, but we're gonna contrive this. So this is an attachment. Here are my options down here. Oh, I didn't create it yet, it's SK, I said that's my option. Now I've created my attachment, and my options are the position right here. The position says, don't you love when I do that? The position says before, and it's attached to nothing. So it comes before nothing. Well, that's not gonna work. Bless you. I'm gonna make it attached before the page, and I'm gonna save and update that. So now, if this were a legitimate example, when I go to look at this page, I'm gonna have this attachment appearing before it, and which may be done, so I can go in and make it appear after the page. And then I can have another attachment to be after the attachment. And I can give these names. The name right here is attachment. I don't wanna have 5 attachment in 20 pages. I wanna give them meaningful names. I have that Leonard.com site, I have views that just like, you know, tempt the edge of your screen, the bottom of your screen, because I have all this crazy stuff going on, okay? I've run out of time, but this is views and CCK. I'm Doug Mann, check me at DougMann.com. My business cards are up here. Thank you so much.